interesting case of a post-pubertal teratoma. So a 27 years old male presented with right-sided neck swelling and testicular swelling. His serum AFP, beta HCG and LDH were markedly raised, so he underwent chemotherapy for a diagnosis of a germ cell tumor. And on biopsy after chemotherapy, the right testis showed maturation arrest and the retroperitoneal nodes showed metastatic post-pubertal teratoma. The residual tumor was composed of hyaline cartilage, columnar epithelium, and there were some nests of round to oval cells with hyperchromatic and pleomorphic nuclei. So this was the scanner view of the post-pubertal teratoma showing various types of tissues. Here you can see the hyaline cartilage, the glands, and some cellular nests. On closer views, these cellular nests showed some round to oval cells with hyperchromatic and pleomorphic nuclei. So what is a post-pubertal teratoma? The testicular teratomas can be divided into the pre-pubertal type and the post-pubertal type, and they generally correspond with the age of the patient in relation to puberty, but this is not always. So in case of the ovary, we have terms like the mature teratoma, the immature teratoma, the malignant teratoma, but these terms we are not using in case of the testis, because there is a well-recognized malignant potential of all the post-pubertal type teratomas regardless of the morphology. So the pure post-pubertal teratomas are 5% of all germ cell tumors, but the mixed germ cell tumors contain this component in approximately half of the cases. So grossly, they are usually cystic and multiloculated. Foci of cartilage are usually evident, whereas bone is infrequent. So in histologically you see all types of tissues, but most commonly you have the neural tissue, the cartilage, and various type of epithelia. And one of the characteristic features of the post-pubertal teratoma is areas of cellular monomorphic spindle cells, which often show circumferential swirling around the glands. Some post-pubertal teratomas have components of the primitive neuroepithelial tissue appearing like neuroblastoma or PNET. In these cases, the criteria for somatic type malignancy must be applied in order to determine the minimum threshold required for classification as secondary somatic PNET. So what is a prepubertal teratoma? Prepubertal teratomas are clinically benign. By definition, they have no association with the germ cell neoplasia in situ. They do not have any genetic gonadal changes. They do not have 12p abnormalities, and they do not have HSN regressed components. And they have structures resembling normal tissue. There is no cytological ATPR. And within the prepubertal teratoma are the dermoid cysts and the epidermoid cysts as special types. So what are the changes in the WHO classification in 2016? Previously, we have the intratubular germ cell neoplasia, but now this term is replaced by germ cell neoplasia in situ. And this term is used to classify the germ cell tumors into those two types, those arising from the GCNIS or those which are not arising from GCNIS. And we have another big change is that the epithelioid and the cystic trophoblastic tumors are recognized as other trophoblastic tumors apart from choriocarcinoma. And the spermatocytic seminoma, which was a term earlier, is no longer used, and now it is called as a spermatocytic tumor. And seminoma now will be only one type, that is the classic type. So testicular tumors in general are classified as germ cell tumors, which are 90%. We have the sex cord stromal tumors, the mixed germ cell and sex cord stromal tumors, and primary tumors not specific to the testis and metastatic tumors. So this is the new classification: germ cell tumors, GCNIS derived, not GCNIS derived. In the GCNIS derived, we have the seminoma, embryonal carcinoma, yolk sac tumor, which can be sarcomatoid or sarcoma NOS. We have the trophoblastic tumors, choriocarcinoma and others. And then we have the post-pubertal teratoma, which can undergo the somatic malignancy. Then the other big category is the not GCNIS derived. In this, we have the spermatocytic tumor. The spermatocytic tumor can be associated with sarcoma. We have the yolk sac tumor, prepubertal type, and the teratoma, prepubertal type.